Hey guys, this time I will show you how to set up your SD card for OpenTX. There is a couple of reasons why you want to do so. In most cases you will probably only want to have the voice output, which I'm not personally a big fan of, but acknowledge that other people do like it.
Welcome to OpenTX. Throttle warning.
Another use case is that you want to flash your modules or receivers. This functionality highly depends on your setup though. On FreeSky radios, you can for example use S-Port to flash your receivers. A third use case are Lua scripts. They allow you to do a lot of different things. The Agent Light Lua script, for instance, allows you to adjust Crossfire module settings. Another Lua script helps you to change Betaflight settings, although this is nowadays mostly done via the OSD. SD card content always depends on the OpenTX version. If OpenTX thinks that the SD card content version doesn't match, it will tell you so when powering on. The SD card content can be obtained from the OpenTX download page. I'll leave a link down in the description. Go to the download page, select your version of OpenTX. Usually you can see the flashed version of OpenTX on the last page of the system settings. The T-Lite only tells us that it is the factory version. From the date, I'm guessing the latest version is the correct one. Worst case, OpenTX will tell us that it expects a different version. Scroll down and find the SD card content link. Each radio has its own zip file containing all the SD card content. The main difference between the content of the zip files are the images, widgets, and themes. So basically, the screen of your radio dictates a lot of functionality that you can get out of the files on your SD card. But what if you cannot find your radio in the list? This might happen if it is completely new and not yet supported in the official OpenTX releases. You can simply take the content of the generic radios. They are identified by their screen size. I want to get the SD card content for the Jumper T-Lite, but this is not available yet. Instead, I will get the generic version for screens with a resolution of 128x64 pixels. Download the latest zip file. Unpack it to your SD card. Basically, any SD card will work here if it at least has 256 MB of space. So the smallest microSD card you can find will probably be a 4 GB one, and thus plenty. Writing and reading speed is also not critical. Let's have a look at the content. EEPROM. In this folder, EEPROM backups will be saved. Firmware. This folder is intended to store all your firmware files for external modules and receivers. Logs. If SD logging is enabled, this is the place where they will be stored. This is mainly useful for development and debugging. Models. Similar to the EEPROM directory, this is the place where model backups will be stored. The OpenTX SD card version file simply holds the version of the SD card content and is what OpenTX checks on startup to verify that the versions match. Screenshots. A folder to store screenshots. A switch can be assigned to take a screenshot of the current screen. I would also consider this to be a development option. Scripts. This folder holds all Lua scripts and has subfolders to store more categorized scripts. Depending in which folder the script resides, it will be displayed in different places on the radio. Scripts in the tool folder will for example be shown on the first page of the system settings. Lua scripts are an easy way to bring custom functionality into OpenTX, using a well-defined application programming interface. I only ever use the Crossfire Agent Lite script and a couple of scripts I did myself. If you are interested in Lua scripts, let me know and I will make a separate video about them. Sounds. In my opinion, the most interesting folder. It contains all sound files, also called voice packs, that are being played when you for example switch on the radio or lose telemetry. Each language has their own collection of sound files. They are simply WAV files with a specific name which are played when the according action is triggered on the radio. Creating your own voice pack is super easy. Just go through the WAV files and replace the ones that you want to customize. The only limitation is that your WAV file needs to be mono, encoded in 512 kilobits per second and have a sample rate of 32 kHz. Here is one I did myself, using an online WAV converter to resample the source files.
You did it. You powered on the system.
Blah. Blah.
Bad news. Yes! I hope that was some kind of joke.
The last folder, SXR Calibrate, is again a Lua script for calibrating some kind of FreeSky receiver. I'm not really sure why this is in the root directory rather than being in the scripts folder. Also, I've never used it. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. And don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps me out.